Hey there, folks. We're back with part two of our network management update, if you will. As you recall from last time, the board looks something like this. Everything here is attached via screws, except for the Eero, which is using Velcro. So we can move that if we need to. I realize it's a little crooked at the moment. But in today's video, we are going to drill some holes, plug those holes with these hole covers, and then we're gonna run the power cords for all this equipment through those holes and then come out the back to get everything plugged in, okay? It'll make more sense as I do it. I am going to get all that planned out here and then we'll get to drilling. Okay, so I changed my mind on the order of operations. What we're actually gonna do first is we are gonna get some feet on this board. So I'm gonna have a foot in every corner. We're using these little rubber feet thingamabobs, and that way I can keep this elevated as I'm drilling the pilot holes for the cable management. So I'm gonna turn this on its side, get these 4 feet in there, and then we will work on cable management. So I'm using some cheap screws from Harbor Freight. That should work. Swap out our bit. I'm not really measuring for this. Okay. Obviously you saw how well everything held up as it was tilted on its side. It's all well connected. So now we have a little bit of room underneath. Let me show you guys. We have a little bit of room underneath to run our cables. So that's what we'll do next, is I will drill some holes. I'm gonna start with something simple for like the switch, right? So the idea is, and truthfully, I could have done this in a lot of different ways instead of having to drill so many holes, but this is where we are. So I'm gonna start with like a hole right there, and we're gonna drill it. We're gonna put one of these puppies in there. I might have to get the Dremel out just to sand it a little in the middle. I will run the cord down, over, plug in through the back. Plugs in here, you don't see the cord. Beautiful. So let me try that. Okay, so this is basically the idea, right? We have a 3/4 inch hole that I also use the Dremel to sand a little bit further. Run the cord through, and then it plugs in back here. And then what I'll do after I've done all of these is I'll take this wire. I'll probably just make a couple folds and then use one of our cable clips to attach it to the back. But basically, I'm going to do this for every cord on the board. I don't know how many holes I'm going to need because obviously I should be able to fit a couple cords through each of these connectors, right? I assume at least 4. So I'm going to give it a shot. Once I have all these up and running, we'll use some cable clips for our Ethernet cables and we'll almost be ready for installation. Back to the time lapse. So just a little update from the time lapse. I'm sure you could see it, but you know, we're using these cable clips. We're drilling them into the board so you can sort of see where everything goes. Obviously, we'll end up doing somewhat very similar with the Ethernet, but all of our Ethernet is really gonna run. This is basically our Ethernet channel, if you will. So I'm gonna finish getting all this stuff clipped for the power cables. I didn't put the modem cable down, so I don't know. I guess I'll decide what the, I may do that, right? I may try to go through here, come around. One thing that I think you probably saw, right? I have to pull all the cables out because the thickest one is for the ring hub. So I had to do that first. Otherwise the rest wouldn't even fit. But I'm going to keep on keeping on here with the cable clips. I'll keep you guys posted. And instead of another time lapse, I'll just come back when I have all this done. And when we're working on Ethernet. All right, I am loving the progress that we're making here. So all of the cables are now attached. I still have a little bit of work to do on the back of this thing, but all in all, it's not that bad. So what I'll probably do is get my label maker out and label each of these so I know where all the cords are coming and going to and from. But by and large, this stuff is pretty well tacked down. It's not going to go anywhere. You know, the one thing that's bad about this design, admittedly, is that the cable clips that I have don't allow me to just very easily make changes. If I want to move this stuff, I'm going to have to unscrew it and rescrew it. But it's what I have, so it's what I'm going to go with. I'm going to do the same thing now with the Ethernet cable, and I will check back in with you all when we are ready to plug it in. All right. There she is. Honestly, one of my favorite builds ever. I think it looks pretty clean. I think there's a couple of things that are not great about it, right? In hindsight, I mean, the modem could have been a little bit higher. All in all, there's just not a ton of room for expansion, right? Which is generally not something you want to do. And I think that part could have been a little better, but I like the way the cables are managed. The real test will be, you know, when I have to swap something out, how much work is it going to be? But all in all, stuff is attached. We know where it is. We can get rid of what we need to when we need to now. So I'm going to go and install it, and that'll be it.